Parts of California remain under flood watch due to a lingering storm system that has battered the state for days. Another storm, though, a weaker one, is expected to strike Southern California later in the week. ABS-CBN North America Bureau Chief TJ Manotok now joins us with an update on the situation there. TJ, good afternoon from Manila. What more can you tell us?
And good evening, Carmina, from a wet and cold Los Angeles. Well, so far, we've seen some really heavy rains really hit the Los Angeles County and as well as Northern California in the last couple of days. We have seen record rainfall that authorities are saying they're estimating anywhere from 75 to 80% of the rainfall that was expected for a year hit this area just in the last 48 hours. The city of Los Angeles had reported that they have received reports of at least close to 300 mudslides and close to 500 downed trees. Lots of areas in pockets in Los Angeles County were hit by flash floods and mudslides. Again, over 75% of its annual rainfall was reported in just 2 days. Now, California Governor Gavin Newsom took swift action by declaring a state of emergency in the whole of Southern California just upon the storm's landfall on Sunday. And on Monday, Los Angeles Mayor Karen Bass also issued a local state of emergency to, as much as possible, facilitate access to state and federal funds for cleanup and recovery efforts. Now, since Sunday, the city of LA had responded to nearly 500 mudslides and almost 400 fallen trees. They had widespread power outages, and they already have affected approximately 250,000 homes and businesses, primarily in the northern and central regions of the state. Now, many residents have expressed shock at the severity of the storm's damage and are convinced that climate change exacerbates such situations. On Tuesday afternoon, LA Mayor Karen Bass again shared relatively positive news for the city.
We urge Angelenos to stay safe. We are still at zero storm-related fatalities. Though the rain is easing up, we cannot drop our guard.
Casey, officials did say that tomorrow around 5 to 10 p.m., which is Wednesday here, they will be expecting another burst of rain, which could prove to be perilous once again for an already saturated ground. Expect more flooding, more downed trees, debris flows, and other hazards as the storm system slowly makes its way out to the southeast. Casey?
TJ, it's a devastation never before seen. What are they telling you about the turnaround time? How will things, when are they expected to, for things to go back to normal, TJ?
Well, that's the thing. They are expressing for residents to be patient as much as possible, continue to be vigilant and cautious. Like just today, I was driving through LA, drove through the hillsides, and actually drove through some of the streets that did see massive mudslides. You can still see the mud on the sides of the streets. When you take a peek to the side streets and the main streets, you still see them covered in heavy mud. And that's the problem here. It may not be flooding in some areas, but since the topography of LA is quite unique, you've got valleys, you've got hills, you've got little mountains here and there, the potential for mudslides is the danger really here, where you don't see it coming. It just did all of a sudden, the soil underneath Kenny Road, like some reports were saying that there's this one house, luckily no one was living in there, that's the one that collapsed. But the debris and the mud that brought down to the other streets and the other homes in the area was what made much of an impact. So again, they're expressing to the community to be patient. They haven't seen anything like this in a very long time. I think they're saying something like, since they started reporting amount of rainfall in Los Angeles, this is the third most amount of rain they've seen in nearly 200 years. So this is just a massive, massive amount of rain. It's not yet done. I'm very lucky that it stopped for this hour or so to give you a live shot of the 5 freeway here in Burbank, California. But I expect the rain to continue again later tonight. And again, a heavy burst coming tomorrow afternoon. So they're hoping that people will still stay safe and vigilant. If they need to go out on the roads, don't go out on the freeways, especially in the roads that where you can experience some flash floods and some mudslides. Hopefully the residents are aware of the routes where they live, and they know what's safe and what's not safe.
Because even if the storm system that's coming your way is going to be a weaker one, we have to remember that the area is saturated already because of the storm that you just experienced. So make no mistake about it, it's still going to be quite dangerous, especially for those living in landslide prone areas. But DJ, here's the thing. It may be a natural disaster, what we're seeing right now in the state of California, but what are you hearing? Does this have a tendency to go political, depending on the response from the Democratic government, local government of Governor Gavin Newsom?
For sure, we're going to expect a lot of that kind of rhetoric, Romina, with the elections just around the corner. We have the California primaries happening in just a few weeks, so you can expect a lot of that back and forth wherein, you know, the non-incumbents are going to say this is a problem of the local government, this is a problem of the state government, that they're not prepared for this kind of rain, this kind of flooding, this kind of irrigation. You know, amidst the fact that LA does have some pretty, you know, heavy investment in floodways and whatnot. But, you know, when climate change comes in, when this amount of rainfall comes in, you never know what to expect, really. But do expect this to be a point of contention when the debates come along, when you know, quote unquote, pun intended, mudslinging comes along between candidates, and we're going to try and get the incumbents where it's going to hurt them in terms of what physically can be seen and felt by the communities more than ever. So definitely it's going to be a political thing, but hoping that everybody gets their hands together for the recovery, for the rebuild, for the cleanup more than anything, because you can see the debris. If you're seeing some of the images on your screens right now, the debris that's spread around different parts of LA County and Southern California is just really a bit chaotic. They've done their part as much as they can to start the cleanup, but it's going to take a while. And this is not the only part of California that got hit. Remember, Northern California also got a piece of this storm. We had some downed trees as well there, major power outages the last 48 hours as well. If you're familiar with the famous park in front of the Painted Ladies, the Alamo Park, there was a massive tree that fell there as well. So just, you know, some sites that Filipinos and tourists are used to seeing, they're getting hit by, you know, these natural calamities that they're not used to really getting here in California. They're used to droughts, but now there's just lots and lots and lots of rain, and still some more to come within the week, Camila.
And talking about hit, what's the hit on the local economy? Anything on that, TJ?
No specific number yet, given as an estimate in terms of the amount of damage that must have been done in terms of infrastructure, home damage, but we'll still wait to see until what they're going to come out with those numbers. But right now, the focus really is on cleanup and, you know, making sure that the homes that were maybe affected or even buildings, they're going to flag them. They have specific color coding as yellow flag and red flag, wherein they're going to pretty much tell residents, yes, you can go back to your home. No, you cannot go back to your home. There have been appeals as well for some evacuations the last couple of days, and they may come about again depending on the amount of rain that they're expecting in the next couple of days.
All right, thanks a lot. Our North America Bureau Chief there, TJ Manotok, joining us this noon. Thanks a lot, TJ. You keep safe over there. No sweeping immunity for former U.S. President Donald Trump. A federal appeals court ruled Trump can be prosecuted for alleged crimes he committed during his presidency, including efforts to overturn his 2020 election defeat. The three-judge panel unanimously said, despite the privileges Trump once held, he was subject to federal criminal law like any other American. This brings Trump a step closer to an unprecedented criminal trial. Trump's lawyers previously argued former presidents are entitled to sweeping legal protections and could not be criminally prosecuted unless removed from office. Britain's King Charles seen in public Tuesday for the first time since his cancer diagnosis was made public. Charles smiled and waved to passersby as he was driven the short distance from his Clarence House home in central London to Buckingham Palace. Meanwhile, Prince Harry flew to London after news broke out about his father's condition. The British public hopes Prince Harry's return will lead to a reconciliation in the royal family.
Sounds nice. I mean, like, this whole family feud thing seems a bit silly in my opinion. They should make up, and hopefully this brings them together a little bit more.
I mean, you know, he's got to come back to see his father, hasn't he? I mean, it's the right thing to do.
Chile's former president, Sebastián Piñera, dies in a helicopter crash. He was 74. The helicopter carrying Piñera and three others plunged into a lake in southern Chile. He was pronounced dead shortly after rescuers arrived at the scene. The other three passengers survived. The Chilean government has declared a period of national mourning for the former president. A star is born in Hollywood as Filipino actress Liza Soberano walks the red carpet for the premiere of Lisa Frankenstein. Our Hollywood correspondent Yong Chavez tells us more.
Glowing from Hollywood's warm reception and rave reviews of her breakout performance in Lisa Frankenstein, Liza Soberano attended the film's premiere in Los Angeles. It's her first time walking the red carpet for her own movie in Hollywood, but the Filipino actress gamely tackled doing interviews with Hollywood press like a pro.
Sobrang na-overwhelm po ako kasi hindi ko in-expect na maraming, I don't know, like makakapansin agad sa akin. I play a supporting character, obviously, in Lisa Frankenstein, and it's just so overwhelming to hear that people really love my character and they really love like the comedic timing that I bring to the story and everything. So I'm very touched because I really enjoyed the process of making the film, and I'm really just grateful that everybody appreciates that.
With characteristic humility, Soberano says she initially couldn't believe that the film's director, Zelda Williams herself, would convince and champion Soberano to be in the film.
Nag-hesitate ka daw nung una to accept it. Bakit?
Kasi ang nangyari, we were at dinner, tapos sinabi niya sa akin, nakaka-green light lang ng project, Lisa Frankenstein. And sinabi, binanggit niya na meron isang character na hindi pa nakakast. So sinabi niya, try mo kaya mag-audition. Tapos ako, parang yung reaction ko, ha? Bakit ako? Kasi first time pa lang namin mag-meet. So parang, talaga? Ako? Bakit? Anong ginawa ako? That's what came to mind. But she was like, even before meeting you, I've seen your filmography and I've seen your capabilities, and I really think that you would fit the role perfectly. And so eventually I auditioned for it, and I'm so lucky to have got it.
Hot burning.
The actress is grateful for the training and experience that she received in the Philippines, where her career started.
I'm sure that everything that I learned, technical and just like on a social level in showbiz, has prepared me for Hollywood or being here, you know. All of those lessons and learnings that I brought, I was able to use that here. And so that's why I'm always so grateful for the career and the people that I met in my career in the Philippines. And I'm happy because a lot of them are still here rooting for me.
Soberano also shares that she is constantly auditioning in Hollywood and already has a project lined up in development. Despite the stormy weather in Los Angeles, the film's team came in full force to the premiere, including lead stars Catherine Newton and Cole Sprouse, and director Zelda Williams and writer Diablo Cody.
Lisa Frankenstein will be shown in the Philippines on February 7 and in the U.S. on February 9. Yong Chavez, ABS-CBN News, here in Hollywood.